Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Chris Thorne Show. Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Chris Thorne Show. As always, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you're watching my content. And as always, like, comment, subscribe, and share. Ladies and gentlemen, I got a video here that I want to show y'all and want to talk about. Ex-NFL player Tony Beckham, if I'm not mistaken, used to play for the Titans. Well, what do we have here? I salute this man. I give him the Father of the Year award for what happened right here. Y'all know what? Let me say the commentary and let me go here and let y'all hear for yourself what has happened.
The suspect in this case is right now here at the Palm Beach County Jail, but he's only being held in lieu of $1,500 bond. And so that's why the parents of the victim wanted to talk to us. They figure he's going to be out on the streets sooner rather than later, and they want you to know who this guy is so you can protect your children.
Right here. He's right here. He was in between, like, yeah, right here. He was all the way, he was inside of here.
Tony Beckham showed me where he saw the man outside his Wellington home, saw the man looking into his 15-year-old daughter's window.
And I waited for a second, and then I looked again, and I'm looking, and then I see a white male, you know, he's standing by my window, and he's trying to get a better position.
It was 6:40 Monday morning. Beckham was leaving for work. He says the man had his pants partially down and was masturbating.
I couldn't believe it. I was like, is this for real? Like, I thought I was getting punked. You know, like, this is not happening to me.
Beckham yelled at the man, who then tried to run away. He didn't get very far. Beckham used to play in the NFL. He is an athlete.
I called him, like, a department over there, and we just had a good conversation.
A good conversation. This is the guy police arrested, Jeffrey Cassidy. Police say his conversation with Beckham left him with multiple broken bones in his face.
I'm sorry that it happened to me. You know, I'm sorry it happened for him, because he's never going to do that again on this side of town.
I came out through the patio door, okay. And Tony had him sit him over here on the curb.
Amanda Beckham called police, and within a few hours, she had installed darker blinds in the windows so nobody can see in at her children.
If he was that brave to do it right here, I know this is not the first time he has done this before.
I don't know if this was his first time coming here, or if he's been here before, or where he's seen us, or how he picked us out, but it's scary.
Good prayer, and just knowing that, hey, my kid, my family is safe and they're all right, and that guy's off the street.
Jeffrey Cassidy is currently being charged with lewd and lascivious conduct against a victim under 15 years old. Again, he is only being held on $1,500 bond. At the Palm Beach County Jail, Ari Height, WPBF 25 News.
Wow.
The suspect in this case is right now here at the Palm Beach County Jail, but he's only...
How crazy is that? But then again, you know, can I really just say that it's crazy? You know, hold on, y'all. I'm trying to... Okay. Or should I even be surprised to even say that it's even crazy, you know, because, you know, I hear about people times a lot, but it's not very often that, you know, you got people times out in the world or whatnot. So what I want to do is we're going to go ahead and read this article and see just it says a little bit more about the situation before I go into my commentary. So they say he hasn't played NFL since 2007, but Tony Beckham proved he can still deliver a hit when it comes to protecting his family. The 40-year-old Beckham said he caught an alleged peeper Tom outside his Palm Beach County, Florida home, leering through the bedroom window of his teenage daughter and fondling himself. We had a good conversation, Beckham 40, told ABC affiliate station WPBF-TV in Palm Beach County of The Stranger. During the conversation, the suspect, 40-year-old Geoffrey Cassidy, suffered a black eye and fractures to his face, according to the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office. Cassidy was arrested and booked at the Palm Beach County Jail on suspicion of lewd and lascivious behavior. He was being held on a $1,500 bond Thursday, according to jail records. And there you go right there. Beckham said he was leaving home for work around 6:40 a.m. on Monday when he saw the people standing outside his daughter's bedroom window with his pants partially down and masturbating. He said, "I couldn't believe it. I was just like, is this for real?" Beckham said, "I thought I was getting punked. Like, this isn't happening." He said he yelled at the man who took off running. Beckham, a former defensive back for the Detroit Lions and Tennessee Titans. Okay, he played for the Lions too. Quickly caught the man and held him for the police. He said, "I'm sorry that it happened to me. I'm sorry that it happened to him," Beckham said. "He's never going to do that again on this side of town." Beckham said he's worried that Cassidy has done this before. "If he was brave enough to do it right here, I know it's not the first time he has done that before," said Beckham. And that he wants to make the community aware of Cassidy. Beckham's wife, Amanda Beckham, told WPBL-TV that she's concerned about why Cassidy allegedly targeted her family. "I don't know if this was his first time coming here, if he's been here before, or where he's seen us, or how he picked us out, but it's scary," she said. And that is the end of that. All right. Again, now, if anybody who I would label a hero, I would say this man right here is a hero, you know, because one thing I always say, you know, when stuff like this happen with kids, you know, where are the fathers? Why they hardly ever put fathers in a camera, you know, when stuff like this happens? And to see that they finally got a hold of a father to tell a side of a story that's involving his daughter, you know, that brings joy to my heart. You understand? So I'm happy to see this. Excuse me, y'all gonna hear notifications throughout the video. You know, I don't know how to silence it while I'm doing this, so please just bear with me. You know, I'm just happy to finally see a father in the camera that they want to talk to the father, get his take on what happened with something involving his daughter. Now, to the wife who says, you know, she want to know why he targeted their house. Well, I say to you, you got people like this guy who did this bullshit. I mean, they can target anybody's house, you know. So I don't think it's a question as to why. You know, if he used to doing this, then he's going to do it until he get caught. You understand? And the thing is, you know, he just fucked with the wrong family. He got his dumb ass caught. You understand? So now he got fucked up. And now he's in jail. But like the news say, he's finna get out, or he got bail for what he has done. So, yeah, dear. So I don't think he just really just targeted y'all. But then again, he probably did. Who knows? But people like him could do this to anybody. Hell, I can have a daughter that's a teenager. The motherfucker could have found my house, you know, if he was down here where I stayed in Memphis. The motherfucker could have found my house. They probably could have found a little hole in the window and looking at my baby and doing this shit that he's been doing. All right. So, hey, you know, I have no problem with this story at all. This man did what I felt that he need to do. You know what I'm saying? He got the motherfucker and he handled his business. Now, some of y'all might come in and say that, he didn't have to hit him, you know, just in the third. Now, I agree with you, man. He probably could have got him and pinned him down and, you know, waited till the cops got there. But that's all about your opinion, you know, how you feel like, you know, how you should have handled it. You know, some people just ain't with violence. There's a lot of people, it's all about violence, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people probably would say, I would have knocked his ass out, too. I would have knocked his ass out, too, you know. And then, like I said, with this story, you know, everything that anybody say, I say, you know, hey, I would have to agree with it. You know, however you would have handled this, you know, I would agree with it. I would agree with you, because the main thing is he needs to be off the streets. He needs to be off the streets. That's all there is to it. This whole ass nigga needs to be off the streets and doing this fuck shit that he's doing to these young children. All right? Now, Brother Beckham must be faithfully in his daughter's life. And to that, I salute him as well. Which I have to say now, it brings me back to the David Bell case, that everybody is up in uproar about. It brings me back to that. Now, y'all see how this father is when it comes to his daughter. Let me ask y'all a question. Let me ask you a serious question. Now, we see the positivity role model in this man right here that we're talking about. So all them young ladies who was outside that mall acting the way they was acting, let me ask y'all this. If all of them had a father like this who is faithfully in his child's life, do you think they even have adult young girls would be out there outside in the mall acting like that? Serious question. If having them young ladies who was outside of the mall acting the way they was acting, if they had a father like this who's protective, who got his daughter back, who would fight for his family, do you think, and positive what it seems, a positive man, what he seems, and made some of himself. Not saying they necessarily got to be a football star, a movie star, but the thing about it is this man going to do what it takes to protect his family, and he's there in his daughter's life. Do you think that if half of those young ladies that was outside their mall had a father like this, do you think they'd be acting the way they was acting? Me personally, I don't think they would have at all. What they would have done is get the fuck up out of there and try to get their ass straight home. All right? And mainly, they wouldn't be acting like they're being disrespectful, period. If they mother or father had to drop them off at their mall and they seen some shit was getting ready to get stirred up, what they would have done? Daddy, come get me. Something finna go down and I'm feeling unsafe. Come get me, Daddy. Something finna go down. I don't like what's going on. These girls, they harassing this woman, this man trying to break it up. They sit up here pushing this man. They out here cussing. They hooting and hollering. I don't want to be a part of it, Dad. So can you please come get me? And you know what he probably would have done? All right, baby, I'm on my way. And he would have came and got his baby. Because his baby would have been taught not to be out there doing that dumb shit trying to impress your friends. Alright? The thing is for you to stay out of trouble. Because I do believe it at the wrong place at the wrong time. So you get caught up in the in crowd at the wrong place at the wrong time, then baby, you're going to get in trouble too. They're going to automatically assume that you had something to do with it too. It's just the way of the world. And you probably had nothing to do with it. But by you being in the in crowd, they're going to look at you and say, you had something to do with it too, baby. And I don't want that on you. Again, I want you to have my legacy. All right? I want the world to know that you had a damn good father. And that's what I see with this man right here. Damn good father. At least for what we've seen right here. This man did what he was supposed to do. He caught a man sexual gratifying himself, looking at his baby. And he caught the motherfucker. And he handled his business. Because think about this. What if he never caught the man? The man probably tried to win so deep as next time try to get inside her bedroom and God knows do what to his baby. So, Brother Tony Beckham, salute to you, brother. Salute to you, brother. And we need more fathers like you. More fathers like you to teach our children, especially our young girls, that I am here to protect you. I'm going to pick you up when you fall. I'm going to lift you up when you down. But at the same time, I want you to understand, I am your father and your friend last. My job is to protect you. My job is to educate you. And everything that I'm supposed to do to you as a father until you up in age or until I'm dead and gone. But I'm going to make sure you, as my daughter, my baby, you're going to have the best understanding in this world before I leave or by the time you get grown, if I live long enough to see you get grown. All right? That's my duty. But not only for his baby girl, for his son too. Same thing. But considering that we talk about his young daughter, we talk about his young daughter, especially young daughters. These young daughters, yes, I think they definitely need a positive male role model in the house, if not the biological father. All right? Anyway, good people, thank y'all for listening. Thank you for watching. Tell me what you think about this. Do you agree with me? Which I'm pretty much sure y'all should agree with me on this one. I shouldn't get no bullshit, but then again, you know how people is. You know how people is. You know, so it is what it is. But other than that, though, yeah, you have to compare this to the situation that happened with David Bell. Again, them girls out there had a man like this in their life, a father like this. I doubt even half of them would have been acting the way they was acting. And that's my take on it. What's y'all's? It's your man, Chris Thorns. Thanks for listening.